This video is brought to you by the California Lawyers Association, a nonprofit organization of lawyers throughout California. Please note that this video is intended to provide general information and does not constitute as legal advice. The information in this video is based on the rules in place as of today's date, September
15th, 2020. Hi, my name is Susan Barrett. I'm a family law attorney in Sonoma County, California. And in this video today, I'd like to explain how people can use a nomination of guardian in order to protect their children in the event that they might be detained by immigration enforcement officials. A guardianship is a process that allows somebody to nominate another person who's not a child's parent to act essentially as the parent. They have most of the same duties and rights that a parent would, but they're just not a parent. They can get medical insurance for a child, they can enroll a child in school, and they can select a doctor for a child. There is a form that the state of California puts out called a guardianship pamphlet. The form number is GC205. We've attached a copy of that with this presentation. That explains a little bit about exactly what a guardian is, how they work, and what the process is in order to appoint a guardian. In choosing who you should nominate to be the guardian of your child, a person has to be over 18. It's certainly a good idea if they're a legal resident. And it should be somebody that you trust and who is actually willing and committed to step in and act as the parent for your child, especially if it's a situation where you may be away from your child for a longer period of time. Ideally, if you can find somebody who's familiar with your child, who even potentially lives in the same school district, or at least knows your child well enough to step in and act as parent, that's ideal. As you select the person who is going to act as the guardian, it's important to explain to them that in the event that you're separated from the child, the potential guardian is actually the person who has to file a court case and be appointed as the guardian. In this process we're talking about today, you as the parent are nominating that person. So the form you're signing today, or the form you're completing as we describe in this video, is you, the parent, saying, I've selected this person to take care of my child while I'm absent, and your hope is that a judge will follow the parent's wishes and nominate that person. So there is a form also put out by the state of California called Duties of Guardian. The form number is GC248, it's a five-page form. We've included a copy with this presentation also that just, it lists all of the various duties that the person is to undertake in taking care of your child. So it's a good idea to review that with the person and just make sure they're comfortable taking on those responsibilities. You also want to discuss with the potential guardian where you plan to keep the signed nomination form. We haven't shown you that form yet in this presentation, but it's the one we'll be explaining how to complete. So once you've signed that form, it's important to keep it in a safe place. You don't want it to be accessible to somebody who might step in and try to take your child from you in the wrong circumstances, but you also want the potential guardian to know where it is and be able to access it. It may be that scanning it and storing it digitally is the best option in a given situation, or keep it in a safe place. You'll also want to talk with both the potential guardian and the children about exactly how they will coordinate between themselves if you're suddenly absent from the situation. So how to let the potential guardian know that you've been detained or you're unavailable to the kids. And then depending on the children's age, you may want to discuss with them as well under what circumstances they notify the potential guardian and explain to them a little bit about what might happen. Again, that's depending on the age and depending on the child. So having discussed what the purpose of these forms are, is the nomination of guardian form itself. And I've highlighted the sections that should be completed for this purpose. This form is used for three different purposes. It can be a consent, it can be a nomination, or it can be a consent and waiver of notice. We're using it as a nomination. So in the top left section of the form, you will enter your name, your address, your phone number, and then your name here. In this section for the court will be the county where the child resides at the time the case is actually filed. So it's not important to fill that in right now. You'll check guardianship of the person and enter the name of the child or children. You can use one guardianship proceeding to nominate a guardian or guardians of multiple children within the same family. So we're nominating a guardian of the person of your child or children. So we check the nomination of guardian box to indicate that's what we're using this form for. And then we go down to section two. You'll check, I am a parent of the minor, and then you'll enter the name and address of the proposed guardian or guardians, if it's a couple, say, or whatever the situation is, as guardian of the person. You'll then enter your name here where it says type or print name. That's the name of the parent or parents. You'll date your signature here, and then you'll sign over here on this line. And that's the entire process of nominating the guardian. So that's you, again, as the person with custody of the child, saying, I'm choosing this other person or persons to act as guardian for my child. A guardianship of the estate, it's not necessary for most children. You can review the guardianship pamphlet to see if there's a reason to include a guardianship of the estate. But typically we're focusing just on guardianship of the person. Once you've nominated the guardian, in the event that a guardianship is actually needed, again, the person that you've nominated needs to actually take the nomination form and use it to file a legal case to request a formal appointment of guardianship. The process, it isn't overly complicated. There are a lot of forms that go along with it. However, so in many counties, there is something called a guardianship facilitator. Sometimes it might be a family law facilitator or a probate facilitator who helps unrepresented parties with these forms. In many counties, there are also legal aid offices or other programs. Some counties have a guardianship clinic that will help parties complete the forms. And the proposed guardian can look into resources in their county for help with the forms. And of course, attorneys can always help as well. This is just the blank form of the nomination the form that we just went over how to complete. And then I've just included blanks of the guardianship pamphlet and the duties of guardian for your information. And I hope that is helpful in planning for a time when you may be absent from your children, but you want to ensure that they go to somebody that they know that you trust, and that you're comfortable having custody of your children. Thanks so much.
Please remember that the information provided is not legal advice and is based on the rules in effect as of today's date, September 15th, 2020. Thank you.